The man accused of killing a Burlington woman in 2010 was in court today. A judge ruled Jose Pazos not mentally fit for trial. But now the state has to decide where Pazos will go. WPTZ's David Schneider joins us with the rest of this story tonight. David.
Steph, Jose Pazos faces charges of kidnapping and first-degree murder in the death of Kathleen Smith. The court ruled Pazos not mentally fit to stand trial and is working on the next step, which could be hospitalization. But Pazos has opted not to be in many of his court hearings, claiming there's a plot to deny him justice and that today's hearing was just a charade.
I think it's flawed from the beginning, and I think I can demonstrate that eventually.
Jose Pazos was in court Monday for his hospitalization hearing. Already declared unfit to stand trial, he says the defense is acting in collusion with the state and the whole court system, plotting against him.
Do you wish to attend the proceedings today?
No, because I don't recognize the validity of them, Your Honor. I think this is a proxy for other issues that are now being brought up.
So Pazos wanted to represent himself, but the court denied that in light of the mental incompetency ruling.
In the meantime, though, Mr. Pazos,
I will not dignify these proceedings with my presence, Your Honor, and I will ask to be removed from the court.
The hearing continued in his absence as the prosecution started calling people to the stand, including a woman who says she knew both the victim and defendant for nearly a decade. She expressed concern about Pazos's mental state when the woman he suspected of killing, Kathleen Smith, was still alive.
It seemed like he had good days and bad days, and there were times on the bad days when he might appear to be angry or talking to himself or, you know, kicking stones in the road. And angrily.
In October of 2010, Smith was found dead in her home in Burlington's Old North End. Several days later, police arrested Pazos in a shed in Middlebury. Investigators reported finding weapons in his bag.
Double-bladed tomahawk, which might be a SOG brand, sort of a copy of a U.S. military battle utility weapon, as I've been told. That was handed out to me, and then I was handed a straight blade, fixed blade, gray knife.